What if I told you that size doesn't matter? That the smallest guy on the team could have the biggest dreams? This is a story of how one man refused to go the fuck home and made a career out of pretending that he belonged. This is the story of Jerry Azumah. September 1st, 1977, in rural Oklahoma. The first son from two Ghanaian immigrants was born. They would name him Jerry Yalsuma Matumbo Shakira Quavo. Mama say mama sa mama kusa, Azumah. It was clear to the new parents that their baby boy was much different than all the other kids.
Even when he was a baby, Jerry acted like a little bitch.
I mean, at first, we thought all the crying was just because he was an infant. And, you know, but even as he got older, you know, the crying and the just acting like a little bitch never stopped. But it wasn't until he was a teenager that we found out that he was diagnosed with LBS.
LBS, better known as little bitch syndrome, is a rare condition that affects one out of every 1 million men annually. This horrible disease not only stunts the growth in those afflicted, but even worse, it just makes them act like little bitches.
I just wanted to get him out of the house, and you know, his mom and I thought if we get him to play a sport, maybe it would toughen his little bitch ass up.
Jerry's parents came to me his junior year, something about him needing some help with his confidence, and they asked me if I'd let him join the football team. Man, I don't normally let bitches on my team, but I felt bad for the little guy. He wasn't very good at all. In fact, we put him in a scrimmage one time, and this dude ran over him so bad, I thought he might have died. In good conscience, I couldn't let him play in a real game, but we needed to build his confidence. So I decided to do one of those things in a scrimmage where we'd hand Jerry the ball and we'd let him score while everyone else would fall down pretending to tackle him.
Look at this little bitch go. If this doesn't get you, nothing will. The kid with LBS never gets into the game. Teammates love him. 10-5, touchdown Azumah.
After graduating high school, Jerry would soon move on to the University of New Hampshire with help from the LBU. That's Little Bitches United. It's a foundation started in order to help those suffering from LBS transition into college. His college years proved to be a time of growth for Jerry. Growth not in a physical sense, but also in the sense of socially. In a trend that would continue for the rest of his life, Jerry had major growth involving his ego. This would lead to some memorable jobs during college. There was this unsuccessful attempt at being an Instagram model, followed by a short stint as Kevin Hart's stunt double. But it's what would happen after college that would change Jerry's life. It was in 1999 that the Make-A-Wish Foundation made Jerry Azumah a Chicago Bear for a day. The poster child for little bitch syndrome was finally going to suit up in the NFL. But what started as a one-day wish would soon turn into something much bigger. It turns out that nobody told Jerry that he was only going to be a Bear for just one day. He thought he was permanently on the team and continued to show up to the practice facility each and every day.
I thought that he was one of the kids and one of the players. You know, you bring your son to work and you know, one of the older guys that just brought their kid to work day after day, and they were kind of overstepping their boundaries. And then later on, I found out that this little kid running around was actually Jerry Azumah.
Bear down! Woo! Jerry Azumah? Yeah, I remember that little bitch. It was like that walk-on in college that would get into the game and everyone would go crazy for him because we felt bad for him. He'd run out of the tunnel with his little uniform on and Soldier Field would go nuts.
The city had never embraced an athlete that rode the bench as much as they did Jerry Azumah. For the first time in his life, Jerry felt as if the player didn't look at his size, but looked at him as a teammate. But the love would be short-lived.
Man, this guy wanted to get in the game so bad. I mean, in between plays, he would grab a ball, he'd run on the field. He would do this stupid little dance, he'd jump around, he'd try to fire up the crowd.
The players and the fans started to turn on Azumah.
This little guy always talking about, you know, if I could just get in the game and play or get an opportunity. No, you're too small, Jerry. You can't get in the game, you can't play. You're too small. Matter of fact, go get me some water, man. You know, your legs are too small. You don't cover enough ground. Those baby legs that you got aren't gonna get it done. All these exceptions for Special Jerry. That's what we called him when he wasn't around. Special Jerry.
Jerry Azumah's just gotta get back to the bench.
Things got even worse the following season when the team announced it was re-signing Jerry. The news? It didn't go over well with fans. Jerry had hit rock bottom. The fact that he suffered from little bitch syndrome was finally starting to sink in.
Looking back,
Azumah became a loner, drinking heavily.
The dance we shared, 'neath the stars above. For a moment, all the world was right. How could I have known that you'd ever say goodbye?
But it was at this point that an angel from his past came back to help Azumah get on his feet again.
I heard Jerry was going through a really tough time. Drinking, hanging out at shady establishments like some place called Paris Club. So I reached out to the Bears with an idea to get Jerry back on his feet.
And the stage was set. In the first preseason game of the year, with the help of the Green Bay Packers, the Bears were going to get Jerry the ball. Azumah was once again a fan favorite. Jerry Azumah's career is long behind him. He has his foundation for others suffering from LBS. He has his family, and Jerry Azumah will always have the memory that for one day, the smallest guy on the field stood the tallest.